Hello friends, my name is Umesh Arya and today we are going to watch this video on Tweet Capturing and Analysis, that is TCA. Just to elaborate about the tweet capturing, it means that we are going to capture or the download all the tweets which are being tweeted on a particular topic and we are going to analyze them. So let's set the background of this in the first place. As we all know that communication has always been at the forefront of human existence since ages. And in this process of evolution, the organic ways of communication, that is person to person, group to group, it has given ways to many computer mediated form of communication. And this novel way of information dissemination has mutated into many diverse forms on the internet. And one of the most diverse form is the social media. And the definition of the social media is that it is internet-based tool and platform that facilitate the sharing of information, including transfer of text, photo, audio, video, and information in general. So basically, we are talking about the Twitter as a social media platform here. And Twitter is also known as the micro-blogging website. The reason being, the micro means it's very small, and blogging, as we all know, that we want to express our opinions on our own personal websites. So that's blogging. So there is no shortage of the space. But Twitter is micro-blogging, meaning thereby you can express your opinion only in 280 words. Earlier it was 140 words. So it's very, micro-blogging kind of thing. So let's define what is micro-blogging. So it is defined as a small-scale form of blogging, generally made of short sentences. And it is used by both consumers and the businesses to share news, post, statuses, updates, and carrying on the conversation. So it's very clear, micro blogging is just a miniaturized form of the blogging. Now let's find out what is the definition of the tweet capturing. So tweet capturing is defined as the process of harvesting or downloading the tweets on some given topic, keyword, or issue from the Twitter, either by manual process or by using API. API is application programming interface, meaning thereby Twitter doesn't allow anybody to just steal its data. It wants to know the identity of the person who is trying to download the tweets on a particular topic. And apart from Twitter, every social media platform which has lot of social data, they don't allow anybody to get away with the data harvesting. They want to generate some kind of identity for that person so that the platforms know that who is this person, and the privacy issues are taken care of. So we'll start with the Twitter capturing tools first, and the very first and the very basic one is the Twitter Archiver. If you enter Twitter Archiver in Google, then you will receive first or two links which are related to this tool. Let me tell you that it is a Google Sheet based tool. It's not run on the Excel or any other sheet. It is an add-on to the Google Sheet, and Google Sheet, as you all know, it in the Google Drive. So it's an add-on which gets attached to the Google Sheet in the Google Drive, and it works by creating certain rules between before tweet capturing. You must have an account on the Twitter, and an app authorization is required, meaning thereby that you have to create some rules before capturing. Means you want to enter some particular words like through Google power operators, for example Ayodhya or Hindu or Muslim or verdict, or you can replace the or by and. And you can delete a particular word if you don't want the harvested tweets to have any one of the words, and you can decide the time period also. And apart from this, you can decide many other factors, and these factors are named as the rules. So before harvesting, you have to create certain rules, then you will be authorized to access that. And very much like the power searching command, as I mentioned, that all the Boolean operators and or they are supported by this Twitter Archiver app. So Twitter Archiver collects the data having 21 variables. It's a quite exhaustive data. The variable they are normally the date, screen name, full name of the author, tweet text, tweet ID, link, and retweet, favorite app, followers, followed, all kind of things. So out of these 21 variables, 15 of the variables, yes, they are quite researchable, and you can leave away the next one. So this was very basic, and you can go to the Google and automatically you will be guided how to use this. So it's very basic. Now we move on to a slightly advanced form of Twitter harvesting. Let me tell you one thing, all these free tools which are being offered right now to you, they can be they can shut off their service anytime, and they can turn into the paid services. So this is a slight limitation with the free tools. So it is highly recommended and strongly advised that you go on using these free tools as long as they are on the internet. If the tools are offered by some public institutions like the library or the public universities, then you can go on using them. So one of the tools like which I'm going to discuss now is the Webometric, Webometric. It is a free tool offered by University of Wolverhampton, UK. And in this, for the tweet extractions, an account is needed on Twitter. That's very good. I mean, no app will allow the data extraction unless you have the account on the social media platform. And for that matter, you have to just download the Webometric. It's very easy. It's very light also, hardly 7 or 8 MB package. And once you open it, then you will be taken to a menu, the menu of the services. So you will see that there is YouTube, there is Twitter, there is Bing, and lot many kind of stuff is there. We will stick to the Twitter here right now. So once you open this, then it will ask for a text file. Now the text file will have to create beforehand. It is created in the Notepad, and it will have all those words which you will require. I mean, these words you want to collect the tweets. For example, I want to scrape the tweets on Ayodhya judgment, then I'll write Ayodhya and verdict and Hindu and Muslim, so that my collected tweets, they are having all these kind of words. And if I press enter and come on the second line, then I can enter a particular hashtag also, and for example hashtag Ayodhya verdict, and in the second line I can define more words which I want in the different tweets. So Webometric will analyze all these lines separately and will try to include the tweets which are having these words. So once it is this file is inserted in the Webometric, then it will go to the Twitter and seek for the authorization. A PIN number would be generated to you, and you enter that PIN number in the window and relax. Then you, on the top left corner, you will see the progress of the tweet downloading. So once the sufficient number of tweets are downloaded, it will stop automatically, or you can cancel the process in between also. When you come to the desktop where you have defined your folder of the harvested tweets, then you will see 3-4 files. You just open the file which is the biggest one, and if you click that and you copy the data and open in Excel, it will have the harvested tweets which are having 8-9 variables like tweet ID, author name, time, place, and the tweet text, following, followed, and retweeted, all these kind of stuff. So some of the tweets are, you know, they are duplicate tweets also, yeah. So they have to be removed using the data function of the Excel and remove duplicates, and all the duplicates tweets are removed. So this way you can harvest the tweets. It's a very simple method, more advanced than web, the tweets archive, which I just discussed, because both the tools differ in the sense that Webometric performs the Twitter search irrespective of the time and space. It just go on tweeting, harvesting the tweets. Whereas the Twitter archives, it performs remarkably up to 1,000 or 2,000 tweets. After that, it will increase the time, and per hour it will harvest the less number of tweets. After that, it becomes paid. So there will be many constraints as far as you know, free stuff is concerned. But yeah, you can go on harvesting on Webometric. So apart from this software, there are explanations, and it is adapted from the chapter on the social media analysis, which I just explained to you. The third method, which I'm telling you, it's very basic one, and I have discussed a lot in the other chapters also, like web data harvesting and Google commands. So this pertains to the Google search commands. A very simple power searching commands in Google can fetch the required tweets, and the 7 days old rule doesn't apply here in this scenario. Let me tell you one thing. In any of the Twitter harvesting software, 7 days old rule will apply, meaning thereby if I am collecting the tweet today, so it will collect the tweet 7 days old. It will not go beyond that. So beyond that, if you want to download, then you have to pay Twitter for that. So it is always better that if some important event has happened and you start harvesting there and then, so that the new tweets are there. So but in the Google search commands, you can bypass this rule, and you can put on a command like site colon twitter.com, and in the double quotes you can enter the keywords and you can put in caps, and then second keyword, and so on and so forth. I have explained this in much detail in our web scraping module. You can go and refer to that. So and set the time frame in the tools. Go to the tools and set the time frame, and you can select the right time frame, and the required number of tweets would be there. Now the only challenge is to how to harvest this Google result data. For that we have to go to the link clump, or we have to take the services of the scraper. We click anywhere in the tweet on the right, right click anywhere in the tweet, and the menu would be there, which will be having the two words scrape similar, and all the tweets will be harvested, though they will not be in the same format, yeah, but there are some limitations to it. Then we will go to the tweet deck. This is the next tool we are going to discuss. It is not a harvesting tool as such, but yeah, let me tell you one thing, that in this tool you can divide your screen into 5-6 columns, and in each column you can run the tweets from various handles. So if you want to keep track of the tweets on different media handles which you have chosen for your reference, then it's a very good tool, and it will real-time update the tweets in the different columns, and you can keep an eye on them. And it is a social media application which has dashboard, and it is used to integrate a few Twitter accounts in order to keep watch on them simultaneously, and that too in the real time. If you apply the scraper command there, scrape similar, then you can scrape all of the Twitter there and then. So that's an additional functionality. There is no single scraping software which can do all the jobs, but we have to be smart enough to integrate the different functions of the different softwares. Yeah. Up till now, this was the harvesting part of it. Now we come to the analysis part of it. So it will be slightly short because it's more of a practical game. And for the detailed one, you can go to the video, which has got all the real-time functionality. So we apply MozDeh for that. MozDeh, M-O-Z-D-E-H. It is again a free university project from the University of Wolverhampton, UK, which is free. And it is window-based, and it searches also it downloads the tweets for you and it analyzes them too. So the thrust is on the analysis part here. And MozDeh can gather 72,000 tweets per hour and can gather data on multiple hashtags, multiple keywords, and multiple Boolean operators all done together. Yeah, it is both a downloader and an analyzer tool. So in MozDeh, what happens when you are done with the project? It will simply ask you what kind of project you want to open, and then you name the project, and it will ask for the keywords, for the hashtags, for the deleted words on which you want to have the tweets harvested. So let's assume that is done, and it's a very user-friendly process. You press next, go to the authorization on the Twitter, and then come back. And then sit and relax comfortably, and it will gather the tweets. So the good thing is that you can keep this running for the days together. The MozDeh collects 7-10 days data. Let me say like this: it simultaneously it can track the real time tweets, and for the days together, 7-8 days, 15 days, whatever. What is your objective? After that, you can stop that, and it will generate a data, and it will show the number of tweets, and then a menu would be there. There would be a simple Google type search box in which you will enter something, a particular word, and press enter. Then all the tweets having that particular word would be there before you. For example, 2 lakhs tweets you have collected, and only 20,000 tweets they have that particular, so those tweets only will be reflected before you. So you can create a small mini project out of that multiple 2 lakhs tweets. Small project, small projects having different type of words, depends upon your research objective. Yeah. And then again, this search box is again having the Google power searching functionality. Like if you want to search those tweets in the 2 lakhs tweets which are having this word and this word, or this word or this word and minus this word, so all these tweets would appear, and then a new project, sub project can be made out of the main project. So this is the very good functionality of that. It means you are covering various aspects of the harvested tweets. Then it can show you the analysis per day and as per the month also, and it can generate a real-time graph. For example, you have collected the data for 1 month, 1 month tweets, and then for every weekend or every day you are putting the pointer, and the real-time data would be displayed like this. So this is a time scale analysis tool also. Then it can find out the gender of the tweet author, and gender-based queries can be answered by the researchers in that. It can generate a database of all the words of the tweets so that a quantitative analysis may be done on that. There are many other functionalities of MozDeh. It can find out the association between two different words. For example, if I am searching the word fake, F-A-K-E, in all the harvested tweets, and then if I go to the word association, then it will show me the associated words which are there with the word fake. and it is showing me the statistical percentage also, and I can relate to that, which are the friendly words with the word fake. And it can find the association also between two particular words. If you enter one word, comma, another word, then it will show the strength of association between these two. Apart from this, it can generate additional lists which are used to form a social network graph, meaning thereby social network analysis can be done having the nodes, small nodes, and those nodes are connected to the different nodes like the balls, and the degree of interaction is there and the arrow is there, meaning thereby the one person is communicating to other person, and this way social network analysis can be done. So it is possible in Mozday. So that was about the tweet capturing and the analysis. Thank you so much.